A breaking, heartbreaking situation for dozens of families in the U.S. after Russian President Vladimir Putin makes it illegal for American parents to adopt Russian children. This was a story that started to break last week, and people were shocked. They couldn't believe it was going to happen, and it actually did. One mother luckily was able to get her brand new daughter out of the country just in the nick of time. Joelle Zeman and 2-year-old Alina arrived from Moscow late Saturday night. Joelle joins me live this morning. Joelle, thank you so much for joining us this morning. That smile on your face pretty much says it all. But I'm sure you were just freaking out, to put it bluntly, in the last few days.
It was incredibly tense in Moscow at the embassy, where families were coming to get their visa in the final moment. It sort of felt like East Berlin as the wall was going up. And it was indeed just a matter of hours, really, for all of us.
So basically, you go back and forth. You decide you're going to adopt. You go back and forth to Russia. You meet this child. You start to create a bond. And at the last minute, essentially, literally the 11th hour, you hear about this shocking move that Vladimir Putin has decided to make. What is your reaction to this?
Well, I knew that the ban would not go into effect until Tuesday, tomorrow.
Right.
But, of course, you know, who knows what's going to happen at the border? Will they refuse to let Alina out? And so I think that what I was thinking, you know, what went through my mind was, what happens to her? Does she stay in Moscow? Do they send her back to Siberia? Will she be waiting for me forever? Will she forget? Will she remember? And I even thought, maybe I ask my firm to let me work in Moscow, which is not a city I would choose, but. So these were the sorts of thoughts that were keeping me awake at night, certainly.
It keeps a lot of us awake just hearing about the situation in the orphanages. Tell us a little bit about what you saw when you were at the orphanages.
Oh, Juliet, it is so heartbreaking, really. Alina was in a baby house. That's what they call the first orphanage, where children are from age 0 to 4. At age 4, they age out and go to a real orphanage, and those institutions are much less cheerful than the baby houses. And I feel like they do the absolute best they can. The women who are the caretakers, they make between $200 and $400 a month. That's it. And they have 16 children who they must feed and get to the potty and walk around outside twice a day, and it's hard for them. But the children are, no one speaks to them, and they don't speak. All of them are speech delayed, and it's a lonely, sad place for sure.
How is she doing right now? How is little Alina doing?
She is actually doing amazingly well. I feel like if it would be as if one of any of us had lunch, took a nap, woke up, and there were these big, huge people who didn't speak our language, who took us off to another planet where everything is different. That's what happened to her, and she's been absolutely fine. She had never left the grounds of that orphanage. She had never seen a bus, no less an airplane. And she's been terrific.
Well, her life has changed, and I can see, and just from your pre-interview, you seem like a wonderful, wonderful, loving mom, so congratulations.
Oh,
and I hope this situation changes just very quickly. You know, Vladimir Putin has basically released statements on this situation, and we've told you what they are. It's pathetic. There really isn't anything to say. These children are being used as pawns, period. No doubt about it. Thank you, Joelle. Thank you very much, and please, our love to Alina.
Thank you, Juliet, and thank you for being a voice for the children.
My pleasure. Believe me.